your whole page. And we talked about this in seventh grade today. Oops, I would take this off. Or just tuck it around. So I like to get rid of the white of the paper. So I'm just gonna tone that in, and this might be scary for a lot of you. But a lot of times in college,
you have to go. I'm just going.
They would want us to not be scared of the white paper, and we'd be drawing, and they'd come and mess it up anyway. Alright, so then
you're good.
Those are the paper towels for if you don't want to get all dirty. So when you leave your figure drawing class, if you're in college and you do this, or if you take a private one, you'll leave looking like a chimney sweep because you usually get all covered in charcoal. Alright. So I'd probably do that more if I go to you can use this. I have chunky charcoal like this you can use. I'm going to use this today because I haven't used it in a while. So now, the basic concept of charcoal is you just want to look for lights and darks. Now, she's in color, so we don't have a black and white picture, which makes it harder. And we're going to try drawing the figure. All right, now, if I was going to draw her, I'm not going to start with all the detail of the top. I'm going to start with, very lightly sketch her whole body out. So I do kind of a line of action to kind of show the direction she's sitting. Get a line for the shoulders, put a rectangle for the torso. She's sitting, so I'm going to do an oval for that. And I just do a stick person first. Okay, right. And it's so light now. I can make some adjustments, like where her head is, shoulders. And now, again. So I'm just looking for big shapes. And put the arm in the chair. And it does not have to be right in the center. I could have done something in a different direction if you want. I gotta make sure
I'm not
easy. Alright, so I'm just holding this sideways because I can get sharp edges. I can use the side of it. So you use this like a little magic. Alright, so I'm just going to gently sketch in the big films. Now, a lot of times we do this on newsprint because it's a lot smoother, but this is better. Alright, what's the darkest part up there? Girl outfit.
Pants.
Everything.
Alright, yeah, so her pants. So, good thing you have charcoal, it's super dark. So I'm going to start blocking this in. And a lot of times in classes you'll have, they'll say, okay, you're going to do a 5-minute drawing. Then you're going to, that was a warm up, then you do a 10-minute drawing. We're not going to have time to really warm up, so we're just going to do it quickly. I'm a little rusty up there. I think that
was...
Alright, so now, once I have that, now I'm going to start refining. I can't really see your feet, so I don't know.
What if... Is it like an alarm?
Now I think, I don't know if there are figure drawing classes in Loudoun County anywhere.
Oh, no. I mean, I don't think I've seen one somewhere in the arts.
Do you guys know Michael Linton? His dad's a portrait painter. His dad teaches some this. Yeah, so his dad teaches this. So now, once I have my finger, now, watch this. I'm just going to use my finger, I'm going to do some blending. And I'm going to look for the part of her face that's dark and light. And her shirt, a little darker than the undershirt. So imagine standing behind a teacher for an hour watching this. After lunch, I'd like to nod off. Mm-hmm. Now this isn't anywhere close to being good. Let's say I've got something to work on. Now, in the old days, Walt Disney wanted to make sure his artists got better, so he started making his animators do this in their free time. So they'd have a studio. They would set this up so they'd learn how the figure really looks. They could study it. Okay, so now I'm looking for parking light. Now you might, at this point, you might want to decide, what do you want to focus on? Do I want to focus on the feet? Probably not. I don't want to focus on the face.
No one can do this.
Since I'm doing the whole body, I might want to just more focus on the face. Now I'm going to look for sharp edges. How are we doing on time? How long have I been doing this?
Five, almost 6 minutes.
So now I'm going to add some highlights in our hair. I'm just using the edge of this. You go, if you twist it as you go, it'll keep it sharp. It'll highlight the chair. All right, now, let's say it's about... This stuff did not erase very well, but you can use it to draw. So these have been around since last year, so we need them a little bit. I'm going to look for highlights. I'm going to start erasing some places. Look for the lightest parts. Especially the cheeks. So it looks like I'm sculpting. So I'm going to get some fine detail with this. I'm going to go in. And then maybe the background, I don't want to get all of those sketchbooks behind her. So maybe to enhance the light coming through, I'm going to darken the background. And that'll make the light part brighter. You guys are probably going to do better.
Mr.
Q,
how do you make white brighter? You add
black. Get dark around. I gotta work on our nose. All right, so you guys, I think you get the general idea. If you start with a stick person, get everything in place, then it's going to, you can define it more. You should have seen some of my professors. Alright, so now it's just some fine tuning and look for lights and darks, little details. And you can get some pretty broad strokes with this if you just hold it aside. You guys, if you do this, you're going to be a step ahead of most people your age. Actually, 10 steps ahead.
10 steps.
All right. Okay, now, what I want you to do, you do not have to stand up like I am. I just prefer it, because I can get my whole body in. But I want you to go find a spot. If you want to stand up, do what I'm doing. You can sit and lean this against the table if you'd like.
I want to sit here.
You can go up by Mrs. Teal if you want, but